Scott, how are you doing today, bud?
I'm good, thank you. I'm very good. I'm trying to stay hydrated, and I'm having a little munch of banana between these things. It's quite intense, though, isn't it? Going on these things back to back is a little bit, yeah.
That was actually what I wanted to ask you. When you're doing these press days, I mean, you're going all day long, 10, 15-minute interviews. I mean, what is it? Do you have like a routine? Do you have some protein snacks you take in between?
You know, I got a banana. I got some tea. English British tea and some water, but that's about it. But no, I to be honest, I think it's I just I'm worried that I just am I repeating myself, or did I answer that with the last
No,
interview?
you're good.
It's but yeah, no, it's a lot of fun though. I know it's great to talk about the movie. I'm really excited about it coming out, and actually, yeah, it's just lovely to talk to people who've seen the movie and they can talk about it. And it's been, filming a film like this is, I just said so much, kind of a bit lonely in a sense, in that you kind of do it, no one sees it, no one knows kind of what goes through it, and then it's nice to share it. So it's actually, it's quite, yeah, it's kind of cathartic, I guess, doing these kind of interviews.
Sure. I mean, we're excited to have you on. I just watched this, I believe, the week before last, and
Yeah.
my fiance was at the office that day, and she got back home, and I said, "Hun, this movie was fantastic." And she was like, "Oh, well, tell me about it, whatnot." But we'll get into that later. I gotta say,
Correct,
Scott,
correct, good.
y'all knocked it out of the park with this one. The
Thank you.
visuals, the acting. I mean, especially when you have two people in such a confined area
Yeah.
that automatically induces vertigo while you're watching it.
It just doesn't, it's horrible.
No, but in a good way though. Like I had those, I haven't had like this good of, I guess you could say, anxiety watching a film, because I mean, it's every second you don't know what's going to happen next.
Yeah,
So
yeah.
as a filmmaker, like how exciting was this a project for you? Because I've seen Heist and a couple of the other projects where you
Yeah.
got explosions, you got everything else,
Yeah,
you
it's
know, but
like,
yeah.
yeah, those, and I learned a lesson with those movies. Like, I love those movies, very proud of them, and myself and Jono, who wrote those films too. It's like but we always felt like cinema is kind of changing, right? Like, and the form's changing. Like, how we watch things as society and what things are worth and why we do it has changed. And I think we that there's certain kind of certain mediums are better for other things. And it was really like with height, like identifying that height was kind of this untapped element of kind of thrills and horror, really. Like, there's bits of it in other movies, but never kind of really something centered around that idea. And I think there is that. What's great about it is having that idea that you can have this like drawn out tension, that kind of one movement this way or that, and it's over. So you have a nice long kind of long leading tension to play with. But we really wanted to look at it like, okay, what's cinema in its purest form? And cinema in its purest form, I think, is feeling something, experiencing something. It's a theme park ride, right? So I think that is what we want to do, is like take the audience on this ride, like, and take them up the tower. Don't like just observe it, but put them into that. And I think, like the other film, a few people have been saying to me that the other film that kind of that did it, like, I'm not suggesting we compare ourselves to this, but like the other film that did it recently that played in that field was Top Gun, right? That like had them in really doing it, and it really captured it. And I'd say that I was overjoyed to see that movie, because finally there was something that gave you a theme ride experience. And for me, with this movie, it's like someone said to me, like, that's like Disneyland and this is like Six Flags, right? It's the intense version of the theme park ride. So I think that was the aim, to do something that really that really used the theatrical experience for the right reasons and really kind of put you there. So that was always at the forefront of our mind, and that evoked a lot of choices and decisions that really, that matter for that form.
Yeah, no, I mean, you definitely captured it, because that was the one thing I was telling my fiance and my friends who I've been bragging about. Hey, I can't wait for you guys to see this movie fall when it comes out, because I literally felt like I was up there with Becky and Hunter.
Yeah, well, I get that's the thing, you were, because they were as well, right? Like, the thing is, like, filming it really at the height we filmed it and capturing it, I think we couldn't have, it wouldn't have felt the same at all. Like, had this been like done in a green, like all the things that were thrown up originally, like green screen and doing all, we even looked at like the back, the LED Mandalorian kind of version, which is like the advanced green screen stuff, really. But faking it wouldn't have worked. And I think all the, what I'm proud of is just the fact that we managed to get up there, we managed to capture it. and do it for real was the big challenge, really. So and I think that really, as an experience, like, I would, you know, in terms of, you know, was it your fiance you said that was with you, or your girlfriend?
Oh, she wasn't there, but I was the one trying to explain it to her. But I know she
I was gonna say that. Yeah, if you show the biggest screen possible is my recommendation. Yeah. The experience does get kind of wilder as you get bigger, so for sure.
Oh, I can't wait, because I only had to, you know, watch it here at home. So when it goes to theaters, I'm definitely going to watch it.
Correct. Yeah.
Can't wait. So the scene was, or not the scene, but the majority of the movie was literally shot off a side of a cliff, correct?
Yeah. It was this huge mountain, Shadow Mountain. It was in the middle of the desert. It took us ages to find this place. It was like, there's a few criteria. One is having like a place with a big drop off. Yeah. Access is almost impossible. I we ended up finding these places by going to Google Earth and hitting an altitude and searching through Google Earth to see which peaks actually offered like the right height. Because it's all like, you're talking about rural, you're talking about the middle of nowhere. They're not kind of marked places of any, you know, it was literally like an abandoned radio hut up there or something. That was it. But yeah, it took us a long time to find the right location. And I think, yeah, the film was as much an engineering feat as anything else, you know, to gotcha. Get up there.
And, you know, what would you say as far as, because I was looking through the press notes and it took you a little while to find, you know, the characters for Becky and Hunter. And originally it was supposed to be a boyfriend, girlfriend going up to the tower, then switched it over to, which I thought was an incredible dynamic. And then don't want to do any spoilers, so we'll leave that for later. Yeah. You know, about what was it with, I think your nickname for Virginia was Ginny, you know, with Ginny and Grace, just their connection, because you could see it on screen, but how excited was that when you saw them audition together?
Oh, man, It just came to life when they did their chemistry read. Like, they done individual reads that were very impressive anyway, right? But they did the chemistry read, and it just came to life. They were the characters, and it was like, and you can feel it. Watch it, and it was on a Zoom, so it's a hard environment, especially kind of going back then when we were all not accustomed to this environment, because you know, typically this would be an in-person thing. It just came to life at that point for me, and they are. You know, they have got the elements of their characters in them, right? And I think there's that, you know, again, without spoilers, right, there are certain elements that are hard to do as characters, and you know, and I think say Ginny, for example, there is an element of like, she, you know, in the way she kind of plays and who she is, and it's kind of, you want to fall in love with her because it's important to fall in love with her. And Ginny kind of just, you'd fall instantly in love with her, even though she's kind of doing some daft stuff. It's like you're with her, and it's really important. And then with Grace, that I loved the, to be honest, it's like a vulnerability of Grace, like that lets you in there. And she's so kind of able to kind of pull out that raw emotion and really capture it in the subtlety, because really, like, you've got these two characters very close together in this small space, and capturing, you know, and playing those subtleties is important, right? And she there's such a range for both of them, right? They I loved it, and they were, you know, really, like, it was a very small kind of environment, and it was just hanging out with those two every day was also a lot of fun. We all tried to put a positive spin on the various kind of biblical nightmares that affected us during production.
Yeah, nothing like shooting in the middle of a pandemic, huh?
Man, that was only the half of it. I don't know if you heard, but we had like hurricanes, lightning strikes. We had like the set blow down one time. We had like infestation of locust ants things that we couldn't. It was nuts. But we ended up like actually surrendering to trying to work against the world, and we leaned into it in the end. And it was like, okay, all right. So like, I remember one of the days in part of the film. Obviously, we've gone to all this effort to film up at a height. And I remember one of the days there was fires in California, as there normally is, right? That time of year. And it covered this kind of fog over the whole desert. And I was like, oh man, we've come all the way up here, we can't see shit. Might as well be in like a white studio. But we filmed, and the fog cleared a bit, and it gave a different flavor. And I remember just feeling like, oh, we just have to go with it, right? Like, we're filming this stuff, we're shooting it. We've got them in that real environment, which means we just kind of film it, have them perform it, have them kind of switch around, and just kind of capturing it around the weather and just getting the scene, completing the scene. It became a lot more a lot more fun in a way, because you're then just directing in the kind of most pure way, and they're getting to perform it in the most pure way, just like in the moment. So in the end, we kind of leaned into the things that were killing us in production and just went with it, and I think that helped with the movie.
There you go. You know, definitely last but not least, you worked with Jeffrey Dean Morgan on Heist before. Did
Yeah.
you already envision him as the father when
Yeah.
you were writing the
100%,
script?
like 100%. Like I love Jeff. Like he's a friend, and we went through like a we had a great film we did together and basically, yeah, like when we wrote The Father, it was a case of we didn't we wrote Jeff, basically. We wrote it for Jeff. It was there was never any doubt. And I was like, look, I've got this part. It's only, you know, it's not many days on set or anything, but it is really huge to the story. And it's so important to get this right, to get, you know, you have a limited time to carry this very important kind of element. So I was thrilled that he was on board. We it was great to work with him again. I love him a bit. He's a star.
He's definitely one of my favorites out there.
Yeah,
So,
yeah.
anything you want to say to the fans out there before they get a chance to preview, which I consider, and I'm not a fan of heights, just to go ahead and throw it out there. Like I said, I got vertigo, but I was sucked in with the visuals and the performances. I mean, you knocked it out of the park with this
Thank
film.
you.
I love it. I
No.
cannot wait for the world to see it. So, any
Yeah.
parting words out there for the fans of Zero
I think,
Gravity?
yeah, I think, well, my words would be to encourage people to watch this in the biggest screen possible and to kind of go with a group, right? And like go with your friends. And if you dare, basically, go to the cinema, strap yourself in and enjoy the ride, is what I would say.
There you go. Well, thank you so much again for your time out here.
Thank
Really
you.
do appreciate you, Scott. Good luck with the film.
Thank
Anything
you so
you can
much.
help
Thank
out,
you.
and thank you for taking time out of your day to be with us here at Zero Dark
Thank
Knight.
you. Thank you very much, mate. All right, it's been a pleasure. Cheers,
Pleasure.
man. Take care.